concept of geodesic curvature. In this higher level theory that I'm hoping to create based on differential geometry, where this is not going to be any more a world line curvature, it's going to be the geodesic curvature in a warped time or a warped space time. So the geodesics are curved in this curved time, and if you look at it within a flat perspective, you're going to get curved world lines instead. If you think that the space-time is flat, you're going to see your world lines as curved. If you realize that that's not the case, then the curvature jumps over to the time, or to the space-time, and then it's the geodesics of that warped time which become curved. And the measure of that curvature is this, that which was the world line curvature. So you need one or the other has to be curved. Either you have your space-time is warped, your time is warped, and you have geodesic curvature, and then you can say that your world line is straight or geodesic, or you claim that your timeline is not warped, like ordinary Newtonian physics, but then you have to agree that your world line is curved. But the amount of that curvature should be the same for the Newtonian regime. Corresponding to this, we found the world line curvature. And then we said in the curved theory, it's not going to be world line curvature, it's going to be the curvature of the geodesics. And this maps to that geodesic curvature, all right? And we can see later that they're actually connection coefficients. In other words, somewhere in the geodesic equation, we're going to have something which tells us how the straightest lines of that space curve. For example, in a flat space, just let's say x double dot equals zero is a straight line. That's the geodesic equation. Second derivative of x as a function of whatever parameter it is, or r as a function, right? That means the curvature is zero, that's a straight line equation, that's the geodesic equation. In curvilinear coordinates, the same straight line okay, so I have this tidal acceleration tensor, gravitational acceleration vector, and this maps to the Riemann curvature, right? The tidal acceleration is really geodesic deviation. This beautiful structure, two tiers, okay? We had the Riemann curvature based on the connection. We had the tidal tensor based on the gravitational acceleration. We know the geometrical interpretation of this is the measure of geodesic deviation. We know why geodesic deviation corresponds to tidal acceleration. It's these world lines which are deviating, and these world lines are geodesics, right? We know why the connection ties to the acceleration, okay? The connection is like a geodesic curvature, and this acceleration is the world line curvature, and one of them is going to be curved, one or the other, all right? Like the geodesic curvature in space. And that's going to map here.